host new entrepreneurs and they want to hear a little bit more about what you guys are doing with Truck Camp, correct?
Yeah.
Yep. And so what are you guys doing? And then what are some of the things that you guys want to learn? And then the rest of the agenda from 5 to 6 will be a demo jam, so you'll see some of the startups here at the incubator present, and I think they'll be voted as well.
Yes.
And so,
who has a mobile phone? With internet access?
So welcome again, and then I'll go ahead and contact you for next week.
Thank you.
Thank you guys.
Cool. Yeah, well, thank everybody for coming here to visit Salesforce and the Salesforce Incubator in particular. My name is Mike Creedon. I'm the Managing Director of the Incubator. And just before I get started, I'd kind of like to know kind of your backgrounds. Like, how did you get to the program? A couple of volunteers?
Neil.
Yeah.
Very good. You've been volunteer.
The application process was a contact form. From there, we had to kind of send like a video, yeah. Like it's a one-way video of like answering 10 questions, where our mentor, Alvaro, kind of watched over like 1,000 of them and just decided which ones would be the best fit for the program.
Yeah. And does everybody come in here with an idea?
No.
Super early stage. Okay. So you're just on your journey right now, which is great. Okay. So everybody in tech, or is it all across the board? Different industries. How many folks are in tech, software? Okay, or tech-enabled company? Idea. Okay, you got some ideas going. I like it. So the Salesforce Incubator is, in particular, I'm not sure if you're familiar with accelerator programs and incubator programs. A little bit? Yeah, so that's not what we do here. Okay? So the Salesforce Incubator is a corporate incubator, which means that things that we're doing within the incubator, there's some alignment with Salesforce itself. So Salesforce is a company right now is the world leader in customer relationship management, or CRM, and we've actually moved well beyond it. So Salesforce this year is going to exceed $10 billion in revenue. We're one of the top 6 software companies in the world now, in a relatively short period of time. Suffice it to say that from the perspective of cloud computing, we're the giant in cloud computing. And the way that we got there was not just because we had an app, which was CRM, that everybody needs and uses to actually manage their customers, but de facto, what Salesforce has become is now the business operating system for our customers. We have hundreds of thousands of customers in more than 70 countries around the world. We have offices in almost every major geo. That's in emerging markets as well as in already established markets as well. South America is very large for us as well, just as an example. But I think what's interesting here is that the opportunity that's being provided within the general ecosystem around Salesforce. We have $10 billion in revenue. There's almost $400 billion in revenue from businesses associated with Salesforce. So you can imagine the size. I'm talking about other application vendors that actually build products that work with Salesforce, that add value to our customers, systems integrators, consultants, and other companies that specialize in servicing Salesforce customers. Huge opportunity. So with that, in terms of how the Salesforce Incubator kind of differentiates itself, or what it is that we specifically do, is we try to help our partners, if you wish, these people that are here on this journey, the startups, understand what Salesforce is and does, and fundamentally become part of what we call the Ohana. That's Hawaiian for family, because our ecosystem is a family, which is Salesforce as a vendor, our customers, and just as important, all of the people that support those customers, which include other software companies as well. That's that $400 million ecosystem. So, specifically, we focus on innovative companies. The reason why we focus on innovation is because we want to inspire our customers. We want them to think bigger. We don't want them to think about just the application that they bought from us. We want them to think about how technology, software, and what it will do for them in terms of transforming their business. The other piece is it's a very collaborative environment. What our job is at Salesforce here in the incubator is to help these startups connect with other people within Salesforce, within the broader Salesforce ecosystem, or with other people that will ultimately help them succeed. That might be early stage in developing the product, or it might be later stage in terms of going to market and building, if you wish, that business excellence and expertise. So what we do is we actually couple that into a five-month program. And what we do over those 5 months is we go through a progression of sharing ideas, some thought leadership in terms of how we've thought about building our business, which is now one of the leading software businesses in the world. And we try to help inspire our incubator companies, for them in turn to inspire our customer base and the broader entrepreneurial base out there. This particular cohort has 13 companies. I'll give you a brief overview of them in just a second. But all of these companies have some element of artificial intelligence that they've built into their solution. So they're using artificial intelligence, AI, specifically to deliver the solutions that they've developed for enterprise customers, business customers. So this is our second cohort that we've done, our class, our collection of startups. In our first cohort, we actually had, Jesse was actually a member of the first cohort, and we invited him in right now. He developed his idea in cohort one in the last batch, and he's actually taking it to market now in the second batch. Besides that, what we have is a new collection of companies, and each of our batches is actually themed. So the first batch was just general, anything to do with Salesforce. The second batch, all these companies in here, as I mentioned, are using artificial intelligence, AI, specifically to deliver solutions to the customer base. Salesforce has an AI stack or platform itself called Einstein, so we're investigating actually leveraging that to deliver the solutions as well. In terms of success, a lot of people look at an incubator or accelerator by basic fundamentals of advancing a startup's cause. A lot of people get caught up in terms of measuring success by the amount of money that's raised. At Salesforce, we actually look at it a different way. So we believe that the best solutions are actually customer-driven solutions, not necessarily technology-driven. And what that means is you don't have a bunch of technologists in the back room figuring out some cool stuff and then scratching their head saying, oh, where's the problem for the customer that I'm going to solve? It's the other way around. So we actually measure, more importantly, by the key metric here, which is how many customers were acquired. So ultimately, engaging with customers, proving the solution. If you're early stage, moving it to where you've actually validated it, so a minimum viable product, and ultimately getting to a point where then you can see line of sight to how to scale the business. The other thing that we focused on also is helping the companies itself acquire the right talent. That usually happens in later stages within the cohort as well. We haven't quite gotten there yet. But you know, a lot of good innovation was actually delivered to market, and we're seeing right now early in this cohort that we have the same promise. The other thing is that this is a living project. It's not just about the current cohort. We're already right now interviewing and accepting applications for our third cohort. Okay, so application process is underway right now. It actually closes this Saturday. So if any of you have the intention or desire to actually join us, by all means, salesforce.com/theincubator. But if you also know folks, in particular what we're looking for is startups across three particular industries. So retail is an emerging industry for Salesforce, so retail solutions. The other one is health and life sciences. And the last one is financial services or fintech. So if you know of any other, if any startups that ultimately want to break into the Salesforce ecosystem, or